Assalamualaikum. Welcome back. Next tutorial. My previous tutorial, I show how to install wamp server and create database and connect database and create a table and show database. In this tutorial, I show how to insert data using insert command and select data and delete data from the MySQL table. Okay, I go to my web server. Yes. I open my browser and go to localhost. Yes, you might be. Go to test database. The test database has three fields: test ID, last name, and first name. And here is, so there are no data at present. So I go to my MySQL console and click enter, because my localhost MySQL password default by null. Okay, I show my database, show data bases, check my database, and here are four database. I work with test database, so connect this database, connect test, and database has been connected, and I check the table from the test database. Show tables. Okay, here are two tables, and I work with test table. I check any data is exist in the test table by select command, select *, from table name. My table name is test, semicolon, enter, empty set. There are no data in, and I check this table from localhost, select test, and here are no data at present. Okay, I insert some data in my table by insert command, insert into test. Test means test is a table name, and field name, my field name is test ID, last name, and first name. Okay, test ID, last name, and first name. The test ID, last name, and first name are table field, table column name, and insert values, and test ID is 1, and I write it by single colon because the name is character as a string. So here, and and close bracket and semicolon and enter. Query, okay, one row affected, and I check my table after insert data. Test. Okay. Here are insert data. First time there are no data. When I execute, select test, and after inserting data, there are one data in my table. That test ID one, last name Sohit and first name Ram. And I go to my localhost and reload the okay. Here are last name, test ID, last name and first name. Okay. I insert next second data, insert into test, CSV test ID, that is the last name and first name. Bucket close and below which data I want to insert in the table. The ID is 2 and name is Abdul Hamid Abdul and close bracket and add semicolon and the okay tutor is effective. And I reload my database. Okay. Test 32, test name Hamid, first last name Hamid and first name Abdul. And I check my data by select command. Select from test. This query actually use show all data from the database and enter. Here are show all data from the database and I want to direct test study one data from the database. So I must execute the delete command. Delete from test. Test is a table name. Where test ID. Test ID. If ID equal to ID, that means test ID. If one is exist in test ID column, the row deleted this column data. Okay, test ID equal to test ID. Test ID equal to 1 and click enter. One row affected. Okay, I check my table. Select from test. Okay. One test study one data does not exist in the test table. If I want to delete all data from my database, just execute this query. Delete from test. Delete from test. Test is a table name. All data deleted from the database and check the data test. Okay, the table has no data and I check it from my localhost and test. Okay, there are no data. If you insert data from your localhost, go to insert button and here are test ID. I write 1 and last name Islam and first name MD. So he and there is a test ID and test ID 2 like Hamid and write Abdul and click go button and you see the query insert into test std last name first name and values, one last name and two digits down, and okay, go button click and check your table health two time insert data. And if you delete the sum data from here, please select button and click that delete button. Okay, yes, click. Okay, and I check the data already exists in here. Select from test table. Okay, test study 1 last name Islam, first name I'm defeated. Test study 2 test last name Hamid and first name Abdul. Okay, if you have any question, please comment on my comment line, and welcome for next tutorial. And if you think my tutorial is well, please click my subscribe button and click bell button for next video. Okay, goodbye.